Hi everybody, this is Ellen. In this tutorial I'm going to show you how to make the Happy Salt Shaker. Super cute, so tiny. I think it turned out super adorable, and of course we have a nice big S for salt on the back. That's how I envision most salt shakers, having the differentiation between the salt and pepper. Happy face, a little bit of salt. If you don't have the clear bands, you can just like make the whole thing white below, just to make it a little bit easier so that you don't have to worry about having all the bands that you need for this particular one. It is almost identical to the Happy Pepper Shaker that I'll have out, but I didn't want to try and like add all the confusing, or it's not confusing hopefully, but add all the differences in the S versus the P in the pepper. So I didn't want to try to do them all in one tutorial, so I just put them in two different ones for you to enjoy. But in this one we're making the Happy Salt, so we'll put them right here. First, we need to make a couple wrap bands, or a few wrap bands for the top holes, the eyes and the cheeks, if you need to make those. The top portion for the little holes is just one band, salt color, wrapped around your hook into a figure eight. And then you grab both bands, and then you pull through two bands that are the color of the top of your shaker. And you don't have to use gray or silver or anything. You can use any color that you want. But you need three of these like this with the salt on them. Then you also want to make your cheeks, which are made the same way, whatever color you want the cheeks, on the hook into the figure eight. Grab the two bands, pull them over, and then you'll pull them through two clear bands or the two white bands. So like this. So you want two cheeks like that. And then the eyes, I'm using the 9mm pointy beads again. I just find that I like the larger eyes on the wider designs. So if you want to make them larger, you'd use two bands and then do what I'm going to do on my hook. Or you can just use the 7mm pointy beads if you still have those. Or just use one band and wrap it around like the cheeks. But if you want the bigger eyes, it's just two bands wrapped around to the figure eight. Then you grab all four, wrap them around again, and then pull them through, or pull two either clear or white bands through. And you'd want two eye bands like that. Or use the beads, but I'll put my bands through when we get there for those. We want one loom, wrong end towards us. And we're going to start with the top, work our way down. And we'll start with a starburst, kind of in the center of our loom here. So I'll come up 7 pins to the center, basically, or close to that. Two bands, everything will be double banded unless I say it differently. Then we'll just do a center starburst around that middle pin. For these, I use gray from Rainbow Loom. These bands that I'm using this time are an off-brand, I think they were Loom bands. So they're kind of cut not so nicely, and they're a little bit different texture, but I'm going to give them a try because they're a little bit, I like the silvery color to them. So starburst around, then two bands, we'll do a cap band, wrap around three times, so one, two, and three. Then go in through your cap band, grab the top two bands wherever they are, pull them up through the center and back towards themselves, and you'll do that all the way around. Hope I don't regret using these bands. They're kind of sticky. Like that. Then we're going to do a row around, and this is where you'll want those wrapped bands that you made for the salt part. I'm going to take one, put it right here. Next spot we'll just have two bands, then another salt band, then two bands, then a salt band. and then two bands like that. Then you'll flip over the bottom four all the way around. These are so stretchy. Like that. Now we are going to increase everything. So I'm going to start over here on the right, on the top here. I can just grab the top two bands, lift them up, and pull them up a pin. Down here on this one, I have to grab all four, pull them down a pin, and then I grab the top two and bring them back to the pin they were on. So there's no crossing of the bands here, it's just that one that flips over. Over on the left side, this top one here, I have to grab all four bands, bring them up a pin, grab the top two, bring them back down. And then down here on this bottom one, I can grab the top two bands, pull them down. So there's no crossing. On the middle pins, I'm just going to grab the top two bands, see where they're coming from. These are coming from this pin right here, so they're going to come over to the left. Then the other two, they're coming from the right, so they're going to go to the right. Do the same thing up here on the other middle pin. My top ones. Those are not my top ones. My top bands are coming from the left, so they're going to go to the left. And the other two are going to go to the right. So it should look like this now. Two bands on 12 pins. Then we're going to do two rows all the way around two bands. Generally when I do designs are like the my growing up technique of how I make stuff. It doesn't really matter if the bands aren't cut super nice just because they kind of are hidden in there. But if like you're gonna do kind of a showpiece bracelet or something like that, then I wouldn't use them, but here they hide pretty well. Like that. So this is our first row, and we'll flip the bottom two bands all the way around. Like that. So that's our first one. We'll do our second row. Same thing, two bands all the way around. That. Now you'll flip the bottom four all the way around. Like so. Push your bands down. So now we're going to reduce, and we're going to reduce every other pin. So starting down here on the bottom right, I'm going to grab the, first I'm going to tuck these on the inside, a little easier. Now down here on the bottom right, I'll grab the top two bands. They're coming from the right here, so they're going to go over to the left, and then the other ones will come to the right. So I'm going to go up to the next pin up here. Grab the top two, they're coming from above, so they're going to go below. Other two will go above. So you just see where they're coming from and take them in the opposite direction. So these are coming from above, so they're going to go below. The other two will go above. So that's the right side. And then come over to the left side on the top here. Grab the top two. They're coming from the left, so they'll go to the right. These two will come down. Next one's down. That was not my rage pin. I just want to try and grab the right bands. That's still not the right bands. You're so sticky. There we go. Top two are coming from below, so they go above. Next two go down. And then one more here in the middle. Top two coming from below, so they'll go above. And the other two will go down. So that's the left side. Push all those down. And then we're going to do a row all the way around. Two bands. So it's kind of long stretches between them. And I realized that I didn't tell you how many bands are in this, but it's right around 340 for the total salt shaker. And then of course will all be in the description anyways, but I usually like to try and say it in the video, but I got excited. So like that. So we'll go around, and each pin is going to have 8 bands to flip over. There'll be 4 reducing bands, and then the 4 from below, from that row before. And you'll be leaving 4 bands on the pins. And sometimes I find it easier to flip over just the reducing bands first, and then the bottom 4. But these bands are so stretchy, that doesn't matter. Like that. So then on the kind of in between pins here, you can pop off those little extra pieces. So we're just on the 6 pins. So now what you'll want are your clear bands or your white bands, either way. And we're going to puff each of the 6 pins that are left. So how you do that is you take 2 bands, take your hook, go through the bands that are on the pin, hook those 2 clear bands, pull them up through, put both ends on your hook, and then the bands that are on the pin are going to come off, and then the bands on your hook will go back onto that same pin. And you'll do that all the way around. Like that. You can pull up your center too. Trying to hook everything. So now what we need to do is we're on these 6 pins. So starting over here on the right side, I'm going to grab the top 2 bands from those clear bands, lift them up, and pull them down 1. Go to the next one up, grab the top 2 bands, lift them up off the pin, pull them down 1. And then we do the same thing on this last side. So now we're back on 6 pins on the right side. I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side, it'll kind of opposite. So this first one, I'm gonna grab the top two, I'm gonna pull them up a pin, go down to the next one, pull those top two up a pin, and the last one here, same thing. Top two, up a pin. So now we're on six pins on the left side. Now we're going to do an alternating double row around our 12 pins. So two bands here at the bottom, across. The next spot is one band doubled. And then it'll be two bands. And the next spot is one band doubled. And two bands, and you just keep doing that all the way around. Those silver bands made my fingers really slippery. Two bands again here on the end. And come around the side, double band. Two bands, double band, two bands, and double band, like that. Then we'll go around and you'll flip the bottom two all the way around. You know, I'm complaining so much about these bands, but I know that I'll end up using them in my other tutorial for the pupper, just because I want the two shakers to be the same. If they turn out and look nice, then it's all good. Like that. So now we're going to do another row all the way around with the clear, two bands all the way around. That. Then you'll flip the bottom four all the way around. Bands down. So now we're going to start adding in some of our bands for our S. So you want your whatever color you want that to be on your shaker. You take that band and we're going to go on the center two pins right here. I'm going to take a band, put it on my hook, wrap it around to that figure eight, which is just a quick way of doubling the band. Then I'll go on to one of the middle two pins here. Stick my hook through the bands there, hook that doubled band, my black band, pull it up through, and wrap it around the top of the pin. And then I can pull it down. So it's wrapped around, and this will go, flip it back over. Same thing for the next one. In through the bands, hook that black band, pull it up through, bring it up over the top of the pin, pull it down, and then up over the top of the pin, like that. Now we're going to do a row around, but before we start, we're going to take another black band, and it's going to go on this third pin down on the left side. So band, put on the pin, and double it. right there. Now starting again with your clear bands, we're going to go around until we get to here and then stop. So two bands in the clear. Two bands. So we got to there. So now you're going to take that black band we put on and flip it up over so it's in the middle of that band, that last one. And then just finish out with two bands. Like that. So then you'll flip the bottom four all the way around. Like that. Push your bands down. Our next row is going to be our eye row, so you'll want your eyes. But before we start on the row, we're going to do is take the band that we dropped into the middle of those bands, and I'm just going to pull it up over the top of the pin like it was before we flipped it back. So it was in the center. Flip it over that third pin down, back on top. So now, starting here at the bottom, two bands clear in the first two spots. Next spot will be our eye. Like so. And the next spot is two bands in our next eye. Be difficult. Now our eye. Then again, come around the side and then stop when you get to here, to the black band. So like that. And then once again, grab that black band and pull it up over the top into the middle. Then finish with the two bands the rest of the way. Like that. Then you'll flip over the bottom four all the way around. Next, we need two more black bands, and we're going to put them on the two pins here in the middle, just like we did before. So I'm going to double them on my hook, and come over here to the middle pins again, pull them up through onto the pin, pull them down, and then flip them back up over the top. That. Push your bands down. So next is our cheek row. So you want your cheeks And we're gonna need another black band too. So starting down here at the bottom, two bands in the first two spots, and a cheek. Then two bands, then another cheek. Then we'll come around, or actually I'll have you put it on right now. The next band is going to need to go right here in the middle. So the second pin up on the left side, we'll take that black band and wrap it around. Now finish the rest until you get to here, and we'll flip that band over. Until I get to there, flip over that black band into the center. Like that. Then our last spot. So like that. Then we'll flip the bottom four all the way around. Like so. Push your bands down. Now we need to put on our mouth band, and that's going to go up here on the front in between these two pins between the eyes and the cheeks. So again, I'm going to do the same thing. Basically, I'm going to double it on my hook and grab it. Take my hook and go in through the left pin, like how I'm holding it here. Go into the bands on the left pin, hook the mouth band, pull it up through onto the top of the pin, pull it up through everything, then put it on top of the pin. Pull it down to the bottom. And I'm going to come over to the right pin, go through the bands there, bring it over, hook my mouth band, pull it up through and onto the top of the pin. Bring it to the bottom so it should look like that. And then take it and flip it up over the top. Have the mouth on. So we need to do another row. We want to come back to this black band that we have on the left side and again flip it up over the top of the pin. So we're going to do a row all the way around and then stop here, flip that band over, and then put that last spot on. Stop here, pull that band over. The last two bands there. Like that. Then you flip the bottom four all the way around. Like so. You can unstick this guy from the middle too if you want. like so. So now what we want to do is we're going to puff all of the bands on the pins with the white, or if you don't have, if you're using white all the way down the design, you probably just would add in, just do a row around for the spot where we're puffing. But if you're using the clear bands to switch over into the white, you want to puff all of the pins. If you're not, if you're using all white all the way down, then just do a row right here. But you need to carry this over if you do that. Put this over, then do your row. But we are going to puff them. So I'm going to take my hook, stick it in through the bands on the pin, grab two bands, the color of my salt, pull them up through both ends on my hook. I'm going to take the clear bands off and then put the salt bands back on to the pin. I'm going to do that for all of the bands around, or all the pins around, rather. Wasn't that long ago that I sent my husband to the store to get us some salt because we were out. He came back with the non-iodized salt, which is not good for me to have the iodine that it, iodized salt provides. I was like, and of course he had to get two big containers of it because he's like, oh, it's only like 50 cents, so we can get a couple of them. So I'm like, what am I going to do with all this salt? So I ended up making Play-Doh with it, which requires an enormous amount of salt. My kids loved it. My walls did not like it very much. And that homemade Play-Doh, it like stains, at least in my experience. It leaves a kind of film on your paint. So, took a lot of scrubbing to get it to where I was like, I want to paint the whole house again. So the moral of my story, always buy the right salt, or you'll have to paint your whole house. So like that, all of them are puffed in white. Then we're going to do is grab that black band, pull it up over the pin again, like that. Then we'll do a row all the way around in the white, and then stop here, flip that band back. Put in that last spot. So again, if you did not puff because you're already doing white, this is what your row should have looked like that you just did. So you wouldn't actually have to do this row if you didn't want to. I hope I'm not confusing people too much. I get to there, then flip over that band again, and then put that last spot in like that. Then we'll flip over the bottom four all the way around. Like so. Push the bands down. Then we need to add our last two cap bands for the bottom of the S here. So I'm going to go in those middle pins again. Same thing as before. Take a band, wrap it on your hook so you can double it. Pull it up through the bands on one of the middle two pins up on top of the pin. pull it down. It might not slide as easier since we don't have the jelly, but pull it down and then flip it over the top of the pin. And do the same thing on the other middle pin. Like that. Now we're going to do two rows all the way around in the white. Like that. Flip your bottom four. Oops. Just throw it around. Like that. Just up to one row. Do another row all the way around. Like so. Set the bottom four again. Push your bands down. Tuck in the ends, and now we're going to reduce basically every other pin. Starting down here on the bottom right, I'm going to grab the top two bands. They're coming from above, so they're going to go to the left. The other ones will come to the right. Next one up, top two bands coming from above, so they're going to go below. Other bands will go above. Next spot up, top two bands still coming from above, so they'll go below. Other two bands will go above. Flipping over to the other side, top two bands are coming from the left, so they're going to go over to the right. And the other two will come over here to the left. Next spot down, coming from below, so they're going to go above. And the other ones will go below. Next ones coming from below, so they're going to go above. Other ones will go below. So now we're on six pins, like that. So do a row all the way around with the two bands. You have to do long stretches for these. Like that. So when you flip, every pin is going to have the two reducing bands, or the, well, four total, and then four from that row before. Just like when we did the cap, so get those all flipped over. like so, like that. Pull your guy up carefully. So now we're ready to close them. So I'm going to take my hook and kind of stick it one of these farthest points. Grab them, take all the bands off the pin all the way around. Be careful of your last pin that you take off. It doesn't pop off on you. All of them are on the hook. Two bands, pull it through everything. Both ends on, make a slip knot, and hide your tail. Then you probably want to give them a little stretch, flatten the bottom, and then you'll flatten the top as well. I can tell these bands definitely reacted differently than the rainbow loom bands, so I'm going to stretch it out a little bit so it's a little bit flatter. It's pretty good. Then you have your S on the back. Awesome. You might have to tuck in some of the bands a little bit, but it shouldn't be. They go in there pretty well, so adorable. Yeah, not totally fond of these bands, but I like the color. See the difference? A little bit. Super adorable. I like them a lot. I hope that you do as well. And then, like I said, the pepper one will be out as well, too. And it's just a little bit different. There's a little bit different. There's an extra row in there, actually. To accommodate that. So take a look out for this one. But I hope that you enjoyed these cutie pies, and if you make them, you can definitely show me on my Instagram, which is at Crafting Fantastic, on my Facebook page, which is feelinspiffy or Crafting Fantastic. They both should find me. And of course it'd be fantastic if you'd subscribe to my channel so you know when I come out with new things, because I'm always trying to put out new stuff. But hope you enjoyed them. Thank you very much for watching, and I will definitely have more for you soon.